Hello and welcome to this technical support video brought to you by the technical support team at FUTEK Advanced Sensor Technology. Today we are going to go over several ways to troubleshoot your CSG110 amplifier. For an informational video on the general setup of the CSG110 and for a link to the CSG110's spec sheet, view the comments section below. Some tools that will help you with troubleshooting the CSG1 amplifier include a multimeter, DB9 cables that connect to both sides of the amplifier, a flathead screwdriver, a power supply between 14 and 26 VDC, and for this video, the test sensor I will be using is an LSB200 at 10-pound capacity. If you are reading either no output or a high constant output on your multimeter, the first thing we should check is that we have made the correct wiring connections both to and from our amplifier. We should confirm that we have matched the wire positions according to the labeling on the top cover of the CSG110. We should make sure that the power source is connected to the correct wires on the power side of the amplifier. The green wire, when measuring voltage, or the white wire, when measuring current, should be connected to the positive end of our multimeter. Either the blue or orange wire should be connected to the ground. As mentioned earlier, the CSG110 requires between 14 and 26 volts direct current. Make sure that the red wire is connected to the positive end of your power supply, and that the negative end is connected to an available ground wire. Be sure that the power supply is off while making connections, as the amplifier is not hot swappable. Likewise, for the amplifier's sensor input, we should confirm that the plus and minus excitation, as well as the plus and minus signal connections, are properly paired with the coinciding connections on the sensor. Note the pin numbers on the CSG110 connectors. These are useful when connecting bare wires to DB9 screw terminals. If there is power going to the amplifier, but you are reading a constant zero or otherwise inaccurate reading, confirm that your load is being applied correctly on the sensor. The proper method of loading your sensor can be found on its spec sheet. For my LSB200, I should make sure that I am only loading in the positive or negative vertical directions and never at an angle. If your readings are a high, constant output, the cause may be a disconnection on the sensor side. Test the sensor on its own to see if there are any opens in the sensor. Next, try removing the sensor from the CSG110 and connect the amplifier's 2 and 3 pins together using a bare wire. This should cause the readings to go to 0 volts or milliamps. If this happens, we can deduce that the issue lies within the sensor or its connections to the amplifier. If you do not read 0, we can deduce that the issue is with the amplifier's connections to power or to the multimeter. Another method of troubleshooting when you are not getting any output is to use the shunt function on the CSG110. The shunt button will use an internal resistor to simulate a load in the system. Remove any load that may already be on your sensor and press the shunt button, and you should see your multimeter change from 0. If you have a small load on your sensor, however, your readings are saturated, this could be due to incorrect gain settings on your amplifier. Open the case of your CSG110 and confirm the gain switches are in the correct places. For a default 2 millivolt per volt sensor, the gain switches should match the arrangement illustrated underneath the amplifier's top cover. For other sensors, refer to our online gain calculator using the links in the comments section below. If you are unable to resolve your issue giving these troubleshooting tips, feel free to contact our technical support team. Given the cost of the CSG110, sending it in for repairs may not be worth potential evaluation, repair, and calibration fees. Also, consider looking into our new IAA100 amplifier, whose link is also found below. Thank you for watching this technical support video brought to you by the technical support team at FUTEK Advanced Sensor Technology.